This moment is a blessed moment.
I'm here to heal you. Believe in me. I am your God.
Lord, I surrender. I have seen your tears. The tears you were trying to hide from everyone around. My dear sisters and brothers, as we proceed to this healing service, let us open our hearts wide and offer in the presence of our God every ache and ailment of our body, as well as all the sickness in our family, and also all the sick people in the world. There are many abandoned sick people, people having no one to care for, people who do not know where to turn to in the moments of their sickness. There are thousands of such sick people in the world. Jesus said something very beautiful. He said, I am come for the sick, in search of the lost sheep, in search of the wounded. That's what I am come for. This morning, we want to wait for Jesus coming in search of us. He's the good shepherd. He's coming to bind up our wounds and the wounds of everyone in the world. Let this be a miraculous hour for us, an hour when we will feel the power, the healing power of our God descending upon us, an hour when we experience the great mercy of our God, a miraculous hour for us. At the same time, let it be an hour of mercy for all the sick people in the world. Let them all experience God's power descending upon them. This is a moment Mother Mary is interceding for us, and all the saints and angels in heaven are praying for us. It's a moment heaven and earth are united. Love is always merciful, and the love of our dear ones who have departed from us and are in heavenly place, their love is also merciful. They are also praying for us. There is wait to experience the intense love of every one of us, so that we may experience God's power coming upon us. Let's all stand up and welcome Jesus into our midst. Jesus is coming to us. He wanted us to know that He's never far away from any sick person, from any sad person. For this, in His compassion, He instituted the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. He wanted to be close to us. He wants us to know that is close to us. That's why the Holy Eucharist. The Holy Eucharist is instituted by the Lord. And there is, when we look at the Holy Eucharist, let's be sure that the Lord is present to us, present to every pain in our body, to every distress in our mind, to everything that bothers us at this moment. Let us sing together in the stillness of our heart. We worship the Lord our God, believing He's coming to heal us now.
In the stillness of this hour, I worship you, my Lord, crying, holy is the Lord on high. In the quiet of my heart, I sing the song of praise, crying, holy is the Lord on high. And for all of my days, I will bow down before you, giving glory and honor to your name. And for all of my days, I will worship and adore you, crying, holy is the Lord on high. Holy is the Lord on high. Sing. In the stillness of this hour, I worship you, my Lord, crying, holy is the Lord on high. In the quiet of my heart, I sing the song of praise, crying, holy is the Lord on high. And for all of my days, I will bow down before you, giving glory and honor to your name. And for all of my days, I will worship and adore you, crying, holy is the Lord on high. Singing, holy is the Lord on high. Crying,
this miraculous hour when angels and saints worship our God, crying, holy is the Lord, we also want to worship Him. We also want to recognize that He has come today as the Good Shepherd to bind up our wounds. Hallelujah.
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 Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I praise you.
I praise you.
I thank you.
I thank you.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I offer to you.
I offer to you.
My body.
My body.
And my mind.
And my mind.
I offer to you.
I offer to you.
Every ailment.
Every ailment.
In my body, I offer to you
all the disturbing thoughts
in my mind,
I offer to you
every burden. On my life.
Have mercy on us.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus. You may take a comfortable posture. We won't to know that God is there for us. He's always there by our side. Let me read for you from the Gospel according to Matthew chapter 8 verses 5 onwards. When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion approached him and appealed to him, saying, "Lord, my servant is lying at home, paralyzed, suffering dreadfully." He said to him, "I will come and heal him." The centurion said in reply, "Lord, I am not worthy to have you enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I too am a person subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I say to one, go, and he goes, and to another, come here, and he comes. And to my slave, do this, and he does it." When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, "Amen, I said to you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I said to you, many will come from the east and the west and will recline with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob at the banquet of the kingdom of heaven, but the children of the kingdom will be driven out into the outer darkness, where there'll be wailing and grinding of teeth." And Jesus said to the centurion, "You may go, as you have believed, let it be done for you." And at that very hour, his servant was healed. The Gospel of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 My dear sisters and brothers, one of the many healing events in the Gospels, in fact, one third of the Gospels are the descriptions of the healings that Jesus gave. In all these healings, one thing becomes clear. Jesus is able to heal only when there is faith. Faith in the sick people. This centurion, the head of a district for law and order, this centurion, a Roman official, he comes to beg Jesus, "My servant is lying sick at home. Please have mercy on him." And Jesus said to him, "I will come and heal him." Now, this is when the centurion expresses all the faith in his heart. The centurion said to Jesus, "Master, I'm not worthy that you enter into my house. Just say a word and my servant shall be healed. And the centurion explains his faith. There are servants who are subject to me. To one I say go, to the other I say come, and they obey me. What does the centurion mean? Centurion means that everything in heaven and earth is under the command of the Lord. For Jesus, a command would do. Centurion knows that when he commands, the subjects obey. Even sickness will obey Jesus. A great faith in the heart of the centurion. And we read this in the Gospels again, again and again. The people were amazed that even the devils obey him. When Jesus would cast out demons, the demons would be gone. And Jesus commands the waves, and the waves obey him. Jesus commands the powers of nature, the powers of nature obey him. Even death obeys Jesus, because the dead were raised by Jesus. This is what the centurion said. My servant is sick. That sickness will obey your command, O God. And this is what we want to tell Jesus today. Jesus said of the faith of the centurion, not even in Israel have I found a faith like this. The centurion was a pagan, not part of the chosen community. And yet, the faith of this man was so strong. My dear sisters and brothers, today, as we are gathered around Jesus, we want to understand who Jesus is. He's come to us in a very humble form, a form of bread, but he's the Lord and Savior. He's the Lord and Savior. Everything will obey him. All your pain, all your sickness, all your problems are under his authority. Near the paralyzed man, in Mark chapter 2, Jesus said, you shall know I have authority. And Jesus exercised his authority. And this man was healed of the paralysis, and he got up and he walked. And this is what we want to tell Jesus. I'm in trouble. I'm in pain. I'm helpless. My family is in trouble. Jesus, for you, it is a word. Say your word, and I shall be healed. Let us place our trust in the Lord. If Jesus is not able to heal us, it is because there's no faith in our hearts. Let's put our whole faith in the Lord. The Almighty God has chosen to come to us in the form of bread. Such a simple form that God has chosen. If God has done that miracle in front of us, then we should know that he cares for us. Because he cares for us, he has come down to us in the form of bread. Let us offer to him everything wrong in our body, in our life. And let us tell him, oh God, I believe you. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, I believe in your love. I believe nothing is impossible to you, O God. I believe you are my Savior. You are my healer. I trust in your mercy. Say a word and I shall be healed. I'm waiting for your power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Chrisane, Tina, Peter, Audrey, the Lord is asking you, do you want to be healed? A question Jesus is asking everyone. A question Jesus asked the paralyzed man at Bethesda. Do you want to be healed? Jesus calls some people by name, but the message is for everyone. For every one of us here, the Lord is asking us, do you want to be healed? Let us believe God's power is descending upon us now. Let's all stand up. Let us sing together. O God, there's none like you. You are a love of authority. Nothing is impossible to your mercy. I believe in your power, in your compassion. Jesus, I am waiting for your word, a word that you will say, a word that will heal me. There is none like you, O Jesus.
There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. Your mercy flows like a river and healing comes from your hands. Suffering children are saved in your arms. There is none like you,
Jesus.
There is none like you.
There's none like you.
No one else can touch my heart like you do,
Jesus.
I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you.
There's none like you.
There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. Your mercy flows like a river and healing comes from your hand. Suffering children are safe in your arms. There is none Search for all eternity long and find there is none like you,
Jesus. Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Please be seated. Let us understand the miraculous nature of this moment. We are brought here by God Himself. Jesus said, no one can come to me unless my Father draws him. Unless my Father draws her, no one can come to me. And we have come to Jesus. And what does that mean? The Heavenly Father has drawn us into the presence of Jesus. If the Heavenly Father has drawn us into the presence of Jesus, it means that God has made a decision on us. God has made a decision to heal us. And that's why God has brought us here. And that's why I said this is a miraculous moment in our life. A moment when we should trust in the mercy of our God. Jovinson, Joshua, Jane, Celine, John. Look at the face of Jesus. Jesus knows your name. Jesus knows your pain. Jesus knows everything that's gone wrong with your life, with your body. Trusting in the faith of our God. Let us praise Him. Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
We trust in your love.
In your love.
We believe.
We believe
in your power.
In your power.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
We believe.
We believe
you are healing us now.
You are healing us now.
We believe.
Believe
your power,
power
is descending.
Upon us
now.
Upon us now.
Have mercy on us. Jesus, have mercy on us. Thank you, Jesus, for healing us. We praise you, Jesus, for healing us. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Let us tell Jesus, Jesus, have your way. The way of Jesus, we have already seen. When the sick people come to him, the way of Jesus is to go out to them and to touch them and to heal them. This is the way of Jesus. We want the way of Jesus in our lives at this moment, that Jesus' power may come upon us. He could not resist the cry of the sick. He could not resist. He could not be indifferent to the pain, to the sickness of people. He came out to heal them. And this morning, Jesus cannot be indifferent to your pain, to your suffering, to your sickness. Let's tell him, Jesus, have your way. Asking Jesus, to come to us in the same way he went down to the sick and the suffering, and the Lord will heal us.
Have your way. Have your way. Holy Spirit, fill our hearts and have your way. As we wait on you. As we pray to you. Speak your word into our hearts and have your way.
Speak your word into our hearts.
As we wait. As we pray,
Jesus,
to you, speak your word into our hearts and have your way.
Speak your word of power into our hearts.
Speak your word into our hearts and have your way.
Jesus, have your way.
Have your way. Have your way. Holy Spirit, fill our hearts and have your way.
Fill our hearts, O Lord.
Spirit, fill our hearts and have your way.
Your way of power, O Jesus.
Have your way. Have your way. Holy Spirit, fill
of God.
Your way,
O Jesus.
Holy Spirit, fill our hearts and have your way.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's a moment when the Lord has chosen to have His way of healing to every one of us here. Some of us have come here with a problem of the eyesight. Your eyesight is failing, and the doctors have said it. Your eyesight is failing. Those who have this problem, please stand up, that Jesus may have His way with your eyes. Jesus, who healed Bartimaeus, the blind man, in the marketplace of Jericho, this Jesus will have mercy on you, and His power will flow into your eyes and heal you. Therefore, those of you having a problem of the eyes, please stand up, trusting in the mercy of our God. Everyone having a problem of the eyes, everyone having a problem of the eyes, please stand up, trusting in the power of God. Some of you have a problem of the knee joints. The knee joints are become weak or even stiff, and hurting. Jesus, who healed the paralyzed, people whose knee joints were stiff and ineffective, the same Jesus is here. He will heal your knee joints now. Those who are having a problem of the knee joints, please stand up. Please stand up, waiting and believing that God will say His word. Jesus, who asked the paralyzed man, "Do you want to be healed?" This Jesus will come to you with the same question. We will answer Him that we want to be healed of the problem of the knee joints. Some of you have a problem of frozen shoulders. Frozen shoulders. You are not able to raise your arms up because of stiffness, because of pain. Those of you having the problem of the frozen shoulders, let us stand up. Jesus saw in the crowd in the synagogue a man with a withered hand. And Jesus saw this man, and Jesus wanted to heal him, but that was the day of the Sabbath. Jesus knew he could not, he was not allowed to heal him. And yet, Jesus was so merciful. He was so compassionate. He healed. He went to this man and said to him, "Reach your hand out to me." This man reached his hand out, and his hand was healed. And those of you having a problem of the backbone, please stand up. A problem of acute backache, disc prolapses, or whatever other problem of the back that causes your backache. Jesus saw a woman hunchbacked, and Jesus had mercy on her. Jesus touched her, and Jesus healed her. The same Jesus is with us. The same Jesus. Only the external form is different. Then in Jerusalem and Samaria, he was in the form of man. But today, he is in the form of bread. A visible form that God has chosen to be with us. Let us believe in His compassion and power. And let us believe that God is healing every one of us now. Those of you sitting down, raise your hands up. Those who are standing up, keep your hands open in front of you. And we want to pray for you. Those of you who are sitting down, raise your hands upon those who are standing up. Let's pray for our brothers and sisters. Let's open our hearts wide to contain the pain of your brother, the pain of your sister. And let's pray for them. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise Jesus. You are the healer. You are the Savior. You are our God. We believe in your power, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. For your graces, for your mercy, for your compassion, we believe in your power. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Please be seated. Those of you who have a problem of diabetes, please stand up. We want to pray for you that God's power may be manifested in your body, in your blood, in your sickness. So if you're having a problem of cancer, please stand up. And the couples unable to bear children, please stand up. We want to pray for you. And those of you get a chronic problem of stomach disorder, please stand up. Those of you get migraine headache, please stand up. And those of you having a pain on the legs, please stand up. Stand up. And those of you having a hearing problem, please stand up. And those of you having a skin problem, please stand up. And those of you having any other sickness, like the fingers gone stiff, please stand up. Any other sickness. And those of us who are sitting down, we want to pray for those of our brothers and sisters who are standing up now. Some of you may have an asthmatic problem, please stand up. Some of you may be having a heart problem, please stand up. We want to pray for you, that God's healing power may come upon you. Those of you standing up, keep your hands open in front of you. And those of us who are sitting down, raise your hands up on those who are standing up, so that everyone here will experience the healing power of our God. God's power descending upon everyone and healing us. Hallelujah. 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 We praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Our brothers and our sisters, Lord, we trust in your mercy. We trust in your compassion, O God. Have mercy upon my brothers and sisters. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy and heal us. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you. Lord, have mercy, Lord Jesus. Your mercy is descend upon my brothers and sisters. Praise you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord Jesus.
Touch me, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let us all stand up now. All those who are sitting down, let's all stand up in the presence of our God. And we want to pray together. We want to pray together, asking God's power to descend upon us, God's healing love to flow into every one of us. We are sick, and our refuge is Jesus. And Jesus has said to us, come to me. And we have come to him, and we are waiting for his heavenly bliss, heavenly comfort to flow into us now. The heavenly power flowing into us and healing us now. Let us sing together, heal me, O Lord.
Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed.
Let's all raise our hands up.
Save me, I will be saved.
Jesus. For the healing.
Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved.
Jesus, I will be saved.
You are the one.
Lord, I trust.
You are the one I trust.
You are the one I turn to. The healing power descending upon every one of us now. Everyone, you are the one, Jesus. You are the one I praise, Jesus.
You are the one I praise.
Let us praise Him for the healing given to us. Praise you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We believe in your power, Lord Jesus. You are our Savior. You are our healer. We trust in your mercy, Lord. We believe in your power. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Feel the power. The power of the Lord now coming upon everyone. Healing everyone here. We praise you, Jesus.
Praise Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Lord Jesus. We trust in your mercy, your compassion, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise. Feel the power, the healing power, a vibration in every part of your body. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. My dear sisters and brothers, some of you, you came here this morning with a very bad backache. Even this morning you felt it, a very bad backache. But now you felt a power, the healing power of God flowing down your back. Vibrating down your back, and your backache is healed. You can feel that. The Lord has taken your backache away. Your backache is healed. Those of you who got this healing, just come forward. Take a step forward to the presence of God. Jesus knows whom He has healed. Jesus knows whom He has healed. Jesus healed 10 lepers. Only one came back to thank him. And Jesus asked, were not 9 persons healed? Where are the other 9? If you feel your backache is healed, take a step forward. God is waiting for you. Waiting for you to thank him. God's power is coming upon you. Come forward. Come forward to praise and thank the Lord. Some of you had a problem of your knee joints. Your knee joints, that pain, the Lord has taken away. Move your knee joints and see. Move your knee joints and see. That pain of the knee joints, the Lord has taken away. Those of you can feel that healing. Come forward. Come forward. Take a step forward to praise and thank the Lord. Your knee problem, the Lord has taken away. Come forward. Many more are coming. Come forward to the presence of God, thanking and praising our God for what God is doing in your lives. come forward to praise, to praise and thank the Lord. The Lord is waiting for you. The Lord is waiting for you. He knows whom He has healed. And some of you, you came here even this morning. Even this morning, you woke up with a headache. You came here with that headache. Now that headache, the Lord has taken away completely. Your head is fresh. And this is a sign. This is a sign of deeper healing that God has given you. Those of you who got this healing, come forward. Come forward to praise and thank the Lord in order to proclaim what God has done for you, what the Almighty God has done for you. Come forward to praise and thank our God, and to rejoice in the presence of God. Rejoice in the presence of our God. And some of you with a problem with your frozen shoulders, you could not raise your arms up, but now without any pain, without any stiffness, you're able to raise your arms up. Those of you got this healing, come forward to praise and thank the Lord. Come to the presence closer, come closer to the presence of God. You could not raise your arms up, but now you're able to raise your arms up without any pain and stiffness. Those of you got this healing, come to the presence of God. Some of you had a problem with your fingers. Your fingers were gone stiff. Now your fingers, you're free with your fingers. Those of you got this healing. Those of you got this healing, come forward. Come forward to praise, to praise and thank our God. Some of you had a problem with the pain on your legs. When you were standing for some time, you used to get a burning sensation on your heel. But that pain, that burning sensation, the Lord has taken away. Those of you got that healing, come forward. That pain of your legs, that pain of your legs, that burning sensation, that burning sensation on your heels, the Lord has taken away. Come forward to praise and thank the Lord. This morning when he got up, he used to get it often, a pain of the ear, a pain, infection and pain of the ears. But during the service, you felt that pain has vanished. That pain of your ears, that pain God has taken away. Those of you got this healing, come forward. Those of you got any other healing, come forward. Any other healing, you felt a healing in your body. In your body, come forward to praise and thank the Lord. Those of you got any other healing in your body, come forward. Come forward to praise and thank the Lord. Any part of your body, you felt a pain vanishing, or any other healing, we want to praise our God. We want to believe that our God is a healer. We want to proclaim to the world where to turn to in the moments of our troubles, in the moments of our sickness. We turn to the Lord. He's our refuge, and He keeps His promise. We want to proclaim this to the world. Let us believe God's power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise You, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank You, Lord Jesus. You are our Savior.
Hallelujah.
You are our God. You are our Savior. You are our leader. We praise You, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank You, Lord Jesus. Praise.
Hallelujah.
Thank You, Lord Jesus. We believe in Your power, Lord Jesus. Praise You, Jesus. Thank You, Lord. Let's all kneel down and receive the blessing of the Lord. Jesus is blessing. Blessing every one of us now. The Lord is blessing us. Let us receive the blessing of the Lord. Jesus blessed the sick, and all the sick were healed. Jesus blessed the paralyzed, and the paralyzed got up and walked. Jesus blessed the lepers and the lepers were cleansed. Jesus blessed the blind and the blind could see. Jesus blessed the deaf and the deaf could hear. Jesus blessed every sick person who came to him, and everyone felt the healing power flowing into them. The Lord is completing the healing now. Let us trust in him and let us receive the blessing of the Lord.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, O praise and God thanksgiving.
So